Well, gonna head round to Blowhole Beach from Aldinga here, 55 to 60 odd k's, just as a good training sort of warm up, because, well, haven't paddled that far before, so what a perfect, beautiful day to do that. And yeah, see how we go. Just beautiful today. And then around the very end corner over there. This is my first time out soloing in this kayak, and don't really know how quick I go. There's no wind, no tide. So it's been an hour. About to find out what we're in for, and averaging 6.5 k's an hour, so. There's my Ponga Beach. I'm gonna have to say goodbye to, I guess, the Metro Coast. And around a series of headlands over there is Karaklinga. Well, 2 hours. And there's just a cheeky puff of wind. It's helping me, so what are we at? 14 k's. No wonder. Spend time solo. You know, it usually only takes a couple of hours before you're having those conversations out loud, and we're not quite there yet. But I kind of look forward to it again. It's just nice. It's just nice to be out again. Well, there's sleepy Karaklinga. There's plenty of people out today though, enjoying the sun. Getting out of the house is great. That's 3 hours, just outside of Normanville, so I'm pretty happy with that. 21. I am getting a bit of a numb bum, which is surprising because I've sat on my bum for the last 2 months, so I thought I'd be pretty used to it. But I've come to the conclusion that there must be a little hole in my little air cushion seat thing. It had to be something, I guess. Just num bum. Yep, time for the hatch. Time for a snake. So this last hour has just felt a lot harder. That wind's just sort of died off. And yeah, it must be lunchtime. It's just like going strong and then just Yep. So no point suffering any longer, may as well get some food in and feel a lot better. Yeah. It's unbelievable, just having a bit of food, like a good bit of food, just changes everything. Thought I was done for. But well, I feel good now, but let's see what happens in 5 minutes. 5 hours and we made it to Rapid Bay. So I'm pretty happy with that. Once we get to a fast rapid head, time for a refreshing drink, I think. The rapid head's sort of ruining all the fun. So this northerly sort of seas has created just flapper slop. Well, at least. Yeah, I was right about the clapperous bit. It's over and the wind's sort of going that way. I'm going sort of that way. So we're friends again. Just tired. We've done about 40 k's now. Oh, this doesn't sound like that many in context of 60, 80, 100. So, hats off to those guys. very much.
So, slow dry down.
We will do this. I will do it. Just the wind going away has taken some of the fun out of it.
What I don't get is those bastards up there are still spinning. They don't spin for no reason. Well, after 7 hours, now paddled the furthest I've ever paddled. We're at 48.2, just near Morgan's Beach. Morgan's Beach. Cape Jervis, just over there. I guess we're about to find out if that tide is running at all. And if it is, it's going to be the death of me. Usually this stretch coastline is super technical, you know. 3-knot currents, that's like 9k an hour water. Last time I came down here, we named it the Travelator, because you just sucked along, but there's not much happening today. Fortunately, not against me, but unfortunately, not with me. 50k, that's just a good feeling, you know? I feel like I should celebrate in times like this, when you're just pretty pooped. You know, celebrate and get spurred on and just know that every K from here is just really good. Blowhole Beach, let's do it.
Well, we're going to try for Victor, but there is a risk of copping a headwind along the dark cliffs, which will be very unenjoyable, but I don't know, it sort of sucks because there's nowhere to turn around if I commit, except for to turn around early and come back past here, back to Cape Jervis. Okay, well, we're ready to go, and the plan is to try and get to Victor, but I suspect the wind might be not very nice to me, so if it is, you know, a nasty headwind, then I'm just going to turn around and go back to Cape Jervis, because I don't feel like doing battle with a headwind till 5 p.m. It's just not fun. Stunning morning. What I'm thinking is I'll go for an hour and see what speed I'm doing. Here we go, into the sun. Quite enjoying that shade. You can see Newland Head now as I come around this corner. And around that is the bluff, and around that is Victor Harbour. Well, it's been an hour and I've done just under 6 in, you know, fairly good conditions. No wind, well, a bit of a headwind at times, but so I'm really, I don't know, really struggling to decide what to do here, because in these good conditions, it's going to take me another 9 hours to get there at this speed. Same as yesterday. And if it deteriorates and becomes a headwind, then I'm really snookered. Sort of makes me think, probably not worth it. Just don't know. Well, I think I'm deciding to head back to Fishery Beach. I just can't see myself having the strength to deal with a 10 knot headwind. At 5 p.m. this afternoon. It's fairly calm out there at the moment, but yeah. I don't know. Just don't think it's quite worth it. You know, I've paddled the coast. I've done it twice before. I've got my big kilometre day in. And I just don't think I need to feel totally annihilated at the end of the day like I was yesterday. Again, as much as it would be nice to go see that coast again and show it, it's a fantastic coast. But as I think, yeah, let's turn around, there's nice, like, peacefulness comes over me, as opposed to an uncertainty of going that way. There's a peacefulness going that way back to safety, and I can't get any phone service, so I can't check, but yeah, it was saying around that 4 o'clock, sort of 1:30, 4 o'clock ish, we're going to get northeasterly winds. I'll show you on here just how detrimental the northeasterly will be, because that's the way. There's no outs along here, and it just would be booming down there, just a slog. And that's, you know, after you've already paddled 40 k's, just to top it off, and there's no outs. There's a 3 meter swell coming in along here, so there's no landing here, no landing there, no landing any of these beaches in one piece, really. And then if I land at Tunks, well, you got that brutal carry up the hill, so that's not going to happen. Neither is Deep Creek or Bodies, so I'm sort of around here now. So the best place to get my boat off the water is Fishery Beach back here, and I think that's just a smart and sensible thing to do. Don't need to be a hero today. Save it for when it really counts. So we're going to turn around. Well, on the plus side, at least I get some time to show you some more of this amazing coastline that's, you know, hard to see when you're walking. But just around that corner is Deep Creek Cove. Yeah, wet fingers. Walking on a tightrope, is open. Well, after 4 hours, we're back where we started. We're floating around, trying to find something beautiful. Sometimes it's like rushing the trail just to find that I'm alone at the top, and I want to turn around, but there's not enough time, so I just want to run. After a swim, very, very cold swim, just fantastic, happy with that. Glad to be on land, 85 k's in the end, 85 in 13 or 14 hours. A strange rash developing there, that's quite sore, and on the shoulders, but apart from that. Can't complain. Catch you next time.